According to his bio page on IEEE Spectrum, quote, David Evan Harris is a Chancellor's Public Scholar at UC Berkeley, Senior Research Fellow at the Internal Computer Science Institute, Senior Fellow at the Center for International Governments Innovation, Senior Advisor for AI and Elections at the Brennan Center for Justice, and Visiting Fellow at the Integrity Institute. And he's a complete moron. He made a guest post on IEEE Spectrum that is a completely idiotic take on AI that you can tell just from the title, quote, open source AI is uniquely dangerous, but the regulations that could rein it in would benefit all of AI. I'm just going to read out the opening paragraph as is, quote, when people think of AI applications these days, they likely think of closed source AI applications like OpenAI's ChatGPT, where the system software is securely held by its maker and a limited set of vetted partners. Everyday users interact with these systems through a web interface like a chatbot, and business users can access an application programming interface, API, which allows them to embed the AI system in their own applications or workflows. Crucially, these uses allow the company that owns the model to provide access to it as a service while keeping the underlying software secure. Less well understood by the public is the rapid and uncontrolled release of powerful, unsecured, sometimes called open source, AI systems. Yes, he's equating closed source with secure and open source as unsecure. He even says it outright, quote, powerful, unsecured, sometimes called open source, AI systems. He keeps switching from the term open source to the term unsecure. He just acts as if open source is insecure and goes from there. It's the typical kind of open source bashing we've been hearing from Microsoft for 25 years, ever since Steve Ballmer bashed up and down the stage screaming about how Linux is evil. Quote, OpenAI's brand name adds to the confusion. While the company was originally founded to produce open-source AI systems, its leaders determined in 2019 that it was too dangerous to consider releasing its GPT system source code and model weights to the public. I think what he means is not too dangerous, but too unprofitable. Because maybe, just maybe, they closed it for reasons of making money, not safety. Of course, there's no evidence for that at all, except for the millions and millions they got from investors when they made that announcement. Nah, must be a conspiracy theory. Quote, other examples of companies releasing unsecured AI systems include Stability AI, Hugging Face, Mistral, Eleuther AI, and the Technology Innovation Institute. These companies and like-minded advocacy groups have made limited progress in obtaining exemptions for some unsecured models in the European Union's AI Act, which is designed to reduce the risks of powerful AI systems. They may push for similar exemptions in the United States via the public comment period recently set forth in the White House's AI executive order. Because Microsoft, Apple, and so many others have done such a wonderful job of keeping our data secure, haven't they? And why is it so dangerous? Quote, you could ask them to design a more deadly coronavirus, provide instructions for making a bomb, make naked pictures of your favorite actor, or write a series of inflammatory text messages designed to make voters in swing states more angry about immigration. Which is already happening with closed source tools. And it happened before these AI tools came out. It's not like there are tons of websites that have faked pictures of naked actors from back in the early 90s. And want to make a bomb? There's this thing called the Anarchist's Cookbook that's been publicly available long before the internet was even a thing. Or you could just look at any given chemistry textbook. Besides, given that ChatGPT can't even cite a legal case properly, what makes you think it could successfully tell you how to make a bomb? LLMs are hallucinating chatbots with delusions of knowledge. Not to really insult LLMs, because that's not what they're for. It's like trying to use a Rubik's Cube for an umbrella. It's not going to do the job because that's not why it exists. It's basically the same old fearmongering. People could use it to scam people, interfere in elections, make deepfake porn, blah, 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 blah. What he fails to mention is the massive benefit to the public of having open AI tools that we can use without constantly being under the yoke of some corporation or government regulator. And, of course, ignoring the enormous harms that would inevitably come from giving the ruling class the power to control what sort of math you can do on your own computer. Basically, take all the arguments against cryptocurrency and just do a search replace and you'll get this article. Or even just strong encryption. He's even calling for an AI version of Know Your Customer regulations. Most of what he's calling for is just idiotic regulations. Number 3, create liability, is the dumbest. This is exactly like saying, a mass shooting happened, so sue the gun manufacturer. He wants coders to be liable for how people use their software. Whereas other measures, such as provenance, transparency of training data, and independent researcher access, are things that come naturally with open source. He wants government to, quote, establish a nimble regulatory body that can act and enforce quickly and update certain enforcement criteria. This entity would have the power to approve or reject risk assessments, mitigations, and audit results and have the authority to block model deployment. And, of course, they'll never, ever abuse it. What regulatory body is nimble anyway? Are we sure this wasn't written by an AI? His second is, quote, support fact-checking organizations and civil society groups, including the trusted flaggers defined by the EU Digital Services Act, and require generative AI companies to work directly with these groups. Yeah, because we've seen how reliable those are. He calls for, quote, eventually creating an international treaty for new international agency to prevent companies from circumventing these regulations. Basically, take the astounding failure of the DMCA and apply it to AI. The most laughable one is, quote, democratize AI access with public infrastructure. But the best way to do that is with open source. Otherwise, he's going to make AI work like the DMV. And none of these will ever be enough for him, quote, these recommendations are only a start. They would initially be costly to implement and would require that regulators make certain powerful lobbyists and developers unhappy. Is he completely insane, or is he just hoping we are? Lobbyists love regulations. It's the lobbyists for Apple, Adobe, and other closed-source AI companies that are lobbying the hardest for AI regulations, because they know that this will just get in the way of competition from open source projects. What powerful open source lobbies does he think there are, anyway? This is just more of the Joseph Goebbels method. Accuse your opponent of what you yourself are doing. Last moronic comment. If actions like these are not taken, companies producing unsecured AI may bring in billions of dollars in profits while pushing the risks posed by their products onto all of us. So, making your software and code available for free will bring in billions of dollars in profits, and closed source won't? There are potential dangers with AI, but the only way these dangers are going to be real problems that we have no way of addressing is to prevent the development of open source models.